I invite you today to join me in prayer as I pray for the Ukraine. The Ukraine is going through tremendous hardship and difficulty at this hour, and we want to pray for the Ukraine that God intervenes and works in a mighty way in this nation. So let's pray together. Father, we come to you today and we pray for the Ukraine, and we lift up the people of the Ukraine. And we ask, Lord, that you would help them at this hour. We ask, Father, that the Holy Spirit would move across that land, Father, that the Holy Spirit would bring comfort, would bring encouragement, would bring protection at this hour in every city in the Ukraine. Lord, we're asking that you would move from east to west, from north to south. We're asking, Lord, that you would protect babies and mothers and husbands and animals. Father, we ask that you would protect the people of Ukraine. We ask that your hand would be upon them. We ask that you would stop the fighting. We ask, Lord, that you would intervene in all the warfare that is going on right at this hour. Father, we pray for your peace, which passes all understanding, to be in the lives of the people of the Ukraine, whether they're in the country, whether they're in another country, Poland or elsewhere. We ask for the hand of God to be upon them. We ask for your protection. We ask for your comfort. We ask for your encouragement. We ask, Father, that you would bring aid, that you would bring food, that you would bring clothing, that you would bring toys for the children, that you would bring food for the young babies. Father, we pray that you would give comfort to the mothers. They don't know where their husbands are. They don't know if they're alive or dead, but Lord, comfort those women. Comfort those children who don't know where their daddies are. Father, we pray that we would remember the people of the Ukraine just as if the fighting was happening in our own nation. Father, we thank you that you have protected us so far, but none of us know what the future holds. And so we want to stand in the gap for the people of the Ukraine. We want to ask that you would stop the fighting. We want to ask, Lord, that you would bring a mighty revival across that land, that you would turn all of this around, that you would build that nation again, that that nation would be a holy nation dedicated to you. Father, we pray, Lord, that you would intervene in this warfare. Father, that you would stop the fighting and that you'd encourage your people. We want to pray for those who are hiding right now underground or in bunkers or in buildings. Father, protect them. Encourage their hearts. Father, we're asking for supernatural healings, supernatural provisions of food. Just like you brought food, manna, to the Israelites, Father, we're asking that you would provide food for those who have nothing. We're asking, Lord, that you would protect those who are fighting right now, the young men. We're asking for you to protect the government of the Ukraine, the president of the Ukraine. We're asking, Lord, that your hand would be upon them, supporting and standing with them at this dark hour. Father, we pray that others' nations will welcome them into their arms, will pray for them. Lord, just again, as if it was happening to us, give us a heart for the people of the Ukraine. And we pray that you would hear this prayer today and that you would intervene in a mighty way and stop this warfare. And we ask this in the powerful name, the mighty name, the King of all kings. We're asking it in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. And I want to thank you for praying with me for the Ukraine today. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you praying, standing in prayer for the Ukraine. Amen and amen. Thanks for being with me. Bye-bye.